हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज़ ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन। लेट्स सी व्हाट इज़ द ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन। ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन मीन्स अ परपेंडिकुलर व्यू। एक्चुअली द वर्ड ऑर्थो रिप्रेजेंट्स परपेंडिकुलर। व्हेन यू सॉल्व फ्यू मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम्स इन दैट वी हैव द न्यूमेरिकल लाइक टू लाइन्स आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर, दे आर ऑर्थो टू ईच अदर। व्हेन द मल्टीप्लिकेशन इज माइनस वन लाइक स्लोप मल्टीप्लिकेशन, द सेम ऑर्थो मीन्स परपेंडिकुलर। नाउ व्हेन वी ड्रॉ द डिफरेंट व्यूज इन ऑर्थोग्राफी मीन्स व्हेन वी ड्रॉ द फ्रंट व्यू सेपरेट, टॉप व्यू सेपरेट, साइड व्यू सेपरेट एंड अदर व्यूज आल्सो, ऑल दीज व्यूज आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ईच अदर। फ्रंट व्यू इज परपेंडिकुलर टू टॉप व्यू, टॉप व्यू इज परपेंडिकुलर टू साइड व्यू एंड टू ईच अदर। सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नोन एज ऑर्थोग्राफिक प्रोजेक्शन। प्रोजेक्शन मीन व्यूज, ऑर्थोग्राफी मीन्स परपेंडिकुलर व्यूज। द थर्ड रीजन why it is known as orthographic projection is the projectors are perpendicular to the plane of projection. Now what are the projectors? Projectors means the projection lines. When you draw a front view or top view, observer has to see the object and the imaginary line, they fall on the plane of projection, means on HP or VP, and those lines are perpendicular to HP or VP. So that is why it is known as orthographic projection. Now what we do in orthographic projection, any object is given in which we have the three views, front, top and side. In one diagram we can see that, but when we have to give the detail of this object, the size detail of all the views, we draw these views separately. Let's say observer is standing on this side for front view. Now we draw the front view separate, draw the top view separate and side view, and similarly we can draw the six views of any object. Now why we draw this orthographic projection? In isometry we can see only the three views, front view, top view, side view, but when we draw the orthographic projection we can design the object from six directions. So this is known as orthographic projection. For example, let's say we have to design a car. When we design a car from this direction only, we can see the views like this. A number of parts are there which are not visible, like the rear part or the back part or the side part. Now what we do, we draw the front view separate, top view separate, side view and then the rear view. And similarly we can draw six views of an object to give complete detail of the shape. This is known as orthographic projection and this is known as isometric projection. Now to make the orthographic projection we use the same quadrant system which we have discussed in the projection of point, line, same quadrant system. Means we place the object, the same car, in first quadrant or second, third and fourth. There is VP, HP perpendicular to each other, two planes, principal planes. Then observer has to stand on this side, standard position for front view, this side for top view. Its front view will go on VP, top view will go on HP, similarly for second, third and fourth quadrant. I have discussed all these in detail in the previous video. You can, if I show the diagram from this side, I can say this will be the point XY. The line will look like XY from this arrow direction. This is VP, the whole HP. This is the fixed position for front view. This is the fixed position for top view. This is first quadrant, second, third and fourth, anti-clockwise. Now the question is why we cannot use second and fourth quadrant for projection system. We only prefer first or third. In India we are using the first quadrant, in US they are using the third quadrant. So why we cannot use second and fourth quadrant? Very important question is there. Now the reason is that if the object is placed in first quadrant or in third quadrant or in any quadrant, I have told you to convert the 3D, means its front view will go here, its top view will go here, even then it is a 3D. Why we have all these quadrant systems? I have told you why we are using these projection systems, because it was very difficult to design the 3D object on 2D. We have decided that we are going to explain the object in different views, but it was very difficult to design a 3D object on a 2D plane. And similarly this one, even these planes are 3D. Now to convert this 3D into 2D, we have decided that we will always rotate HP 90 degree clockwise direction. Now when you rotate HP 90 degree clockwise direction, in the first quadrant, top view or the HP will go down, VP will remain straight. But in second quadrant what will happen? When you rotate HP 90 degree clockwise, this HP will overlap with VP. The top view will overlap with front view. Now in that view we cannot recognize, we cannot differentiate where is the top view, where is the front view. In third quadrant, HP and top view will go above, so no overlapping. But in fourth quadrant, the same like second quadrant, HP, when you rotate HP 90 degree clockwise, it will overlap with VP. Similarly, the front view overlap with top view. So due to this, we cannot use second and fourth quadrant in projection system. We use this in projection of points because point is having only a dot as the front view, dot as the top view. So if it overlap, even then we have no issue with the views. But when a complex object is there, even a line is there, if the lines overlap, it will intersect or it will cross each other. So we cannot identify the actual shape. We will try to understand it more with this diagram. Let's say in the second angle projection, what is there in second angle projection? Let's say we have placed a cone in the second angle projection. Observer has to stand this side for front view. It will have the front view a triangle on VP, top view a circle on HP. We remove this object. To convert this 3D into 2D, we have to rotate HP 90 degree clockwise. When you rotate this circle, the top view, it will overlap with this triangle. And we cannot identify which one is the front view, which one is the top view after drawing. Same in fourth angle projection, what will happen? Let's say I have taken this arbitrary shape object. Its front view will be a trapezium and top view will be two concentric circles. Now when you see the front view and top view, this is the front view on VP, this is the top view on HP. As per the rule, we have to rotate this HP 90 degree clockwise. Now what will happen? Both will come down and the view will be like this. Now here you can see this trapezium is overlapping with the concentric circles. Now we cannot identify from this diagram what is the front view, what is the top view. So even it is a easy object, then maybe you are recognizing the front and top, but when the complex machine part, complex structure is there, we cannot identify. So we have no need to use second and fourth quadrant for projections. It means the remaining is only the first and third quadrant. So what is the difference between first and third quadrant? Again, a very important topic. Let's say this is the quadrant system. We have placed this same complex object in first quadrant and in third quadrant. Now we will differentiate them in points. First object lies in first quadrant. When we say this is a first angle projection, this car or any object is in first quadrant. I have told you there are fourth quadrant anti-clockwise, but in third angle projection, the object lies in third quadrant, here below HP, behind VP, and in first quadrant above HP, in front of VP. Now in first angle projection, we know that this is the position for observer, this is the position for observer. We can say in first quadrant, this car or this object, it is in between the observer and plane of projection, or it is in between the observer and VP, and it is in between the observer and HP, this object. So object lies in between the plane of projection and observer. In third angle projection, I have told you this is the position for front view for observer. This is the position of top view for observer, and we have to assume VP HP as a transparent glass. Now in this, we can say plane of projection is in between the object and observer, means VP HP is in between the observer and this object. Now the third point is plane of projection is assumed to be non-transparent in first angle projection, just like the mirrors. But in third angle projection, we can get the projections only when we consider VP HP as the transparent glass. Only then observer can see the front view and top view through the glass. Now VP is above the reference line in first angle projection, and HP, when you rotate, HP will go below the reference line. But in third angle projection, HP will go above the reference line and VP is below the reference line. And front view is above the reference line. When you see this side, front view will go on VP, means above reference line. Top view will go on HP, and when you rotate, top view will go down in first angle projection. But in third angle projection, when you see the top view, it will be on HP. When you rotate, top view will go above XY line, and front view on VP, it will remain below XY line. Now the symbol is there for first angle projection. This is the symbol. Now what is there? It is actually the front view of a frustum of cone. This is the top view of a frustum of cone. Now in first angle projection, here we draw front view and the top view. Now for the same third angle projection, this is top view of the frustum of cone and this is the front view of the frustum of cone. Now you can differentiate it very easily. Here first angle projection, front view, top view, and in third angle projection, top view, front view. Now we will see what are the steps to draw the orthographic projection. I have told you this view in which you can see front, top, side, all the views in one diagram, isometric projection, And what is orthographic projection? When you have the front view separate, top view, side view, and all other views separately. Now, whenever we have to draw an orthographic projection, you have to proceed with these things. First, we do the identification, levels, inclined, cylindrical, curved, and hidden edges. The main object will have all these challenges. These are not the predefined steps. Whenever we have to solve, let's say I have to solve a problem, I will go for checking of these things in the main diagram so that I can make the orthographic projection. So try to understand. I will explain each and everything separately. I have made the videos on all these things. Separate videos are there. If you are confused, then you can watch those also with the animations. Now, whenever we have to draw orthographic projection, please keep these things in your mind. First, if the angle projection is not given, you have to follow the first angle projection. Mostly the angle projection is given, but in India we are following the first angle projection. That is why I told, if angle projection is not given, go for first angle projection, means put the object in first quadrant. Second, if the drawing is prepared by using a scale, means let's say any big object is there, any very small object is there, you have to design that. It means we have to enlarge or reduce the size of object on sheet. Whenever we change the side, you have to say the ratio also or the scale also with which you are making the diagram. Third, if any dimension is missing, you have to assume the proportionate dimension. Mostly the dimensions are given. Whenever we have a missing dimension, you try to calculate it. They will not give you all the dimensions in all the sides. You have to do the calculation also, but even then, after calculation, you cannot identify the dimension, then you have to assume. Just look at the same ratio of any other surface. What is the dimension? You can take the proportionate dimension. If any hole is there, circular or rectangular or whatever the shape, if the depth of that hole is not given, you can take it, you can assume it throughout the body. If the direction of front view is not available, you can take that side as the front view, in which maximum area, maximum shape, maximum size is available. You can follow that as the direction for front view, because all the views will be based on that side. Then the last one, over dimensioning should be avoided, means unnecessary dimension should not be there. Now we will discuss each and every step separately. First is identification of surface. Let's say this object is given, isometric view. This is the side for front view. When you see from this side, you can see only the surface one. Identification means you have to identify in which view which surface is visible. In this side, you can see only the surface one. Why not this surface? This surface, because they will become perpendicular to your eyes. Just try to see any object placed in front of you. You cannot see these two surfaces which are perpendicular. You can see only one surface which is parallel to your eyes. So you can see the surface one like this in front view. Same like top view, when you go on that side, you can see the surface 2 only. Why you cannot see the surface for 1 and this one 3? Because they will become perpendicular. Same in the side view, you can see the surface 3 only. So this step is known as identification of surface, means identify those surfaces which are visible in a particular view. Now we will go for the next step, that is these levels. Let's say an object is given in this side, and first you have to identify. Every step will be included the last step also. So identification means you have to see in this side, you can see only the surface 1 and 2. You cannot see this surface because it will be perpendicular to your eyes. Same like stairs. If you stand in front of stairs, you cannot identify, you cannot see that surface where you put your feet. So you can see only the surface 1 and 2. And how we have to draw the 1 and 2 just adjacent to each other. In this way, you cannot see this surface, this line, this edge, it will overlap with this, though that is why in the front view you have only one edge for this and this after overlapping, and 1 and 2 will be adjacent to each other. You cannot see the gap in between these. Now what will be the top view? Same, you can see the surface 3 and 4 only. How we draw the surface 3 and 4 adjacent to each other, because you cannot see the surface 2 and 1 perpendicular to your eyes. And in side view, this is the 5 surface, L-shaped surface will be there. Now we will see the next step, that is inclined surfaces. Let's say our object is having one inclined surface, this one, and when you see the front view, the direction is this as the front view, you can now go for the identification, then levels. So you can identify the surface 1 and 2 in the front view. Only these two surfaces will be visible, and how they will look like on the same level. So front view will have the surface 1 and 2 on the same level like this. Now when you go for the top view, you can see the surface 3, 4, 5 and 6 identification is done. Now how we have to make all these surfaces on the same level? But what about the inclined surface? The 4 surface is inclined surface. So this is the thing which I want to tell you. The 4 surface will be in between 5 and 6, but with reduced dimensions, right? And this inclined surface, it will be visible in multiple views, means it will be visible in top view as well as in side view also. So remember that the inclined surface will be with the reduced dimension and visible in multiple views. So let's see one example which will help you understanding these three things: identification, levels and incline. Let's say this diagram is there and this is the direction for front view x side. In the x side you can see the surface A, C and E, but how they will look on the same level, like this A, C, E after projecting in front view. Same in the top view, when you see from this side you can see the surface F, G, but G is an inclined surface, but how it will look like in the top view? F here and G just adjacent to that. Now for the side view y direction, you can see the surface D and G only with B surface. So D, G, B. G is inclined, but it will look like straight with reduced dimension. Now this G surface is visible in side view and top view also. So this is the good example just to understand these three things. Now we will see the next part, that is the cylindrical surface. Let's say an object is given like a cylindrical. So remember that when you see a cylinder, you cannot identify, you cannot see the upper part of the cylinder, but your eyes can see that is only a rectangle for a cylinder. So what will be the front view? It will be having a rectangle for front view of this cylinder and this also. And then what will be the top view? A square with one circle inside at the mid. So remember that when a cylindrical surface is there, it will be looking like a rectangle only. Your eyes can see a rectangle, but your mind can understand the curve part. So we draw only that what your eyes can see. We will see now the curved surface. Curved means a part of cylinder, not the complete cylinder, but part. But it will have the same rule. Straight surface, like in the front view you can see this surface, it is curved here and it is also curved here. So in the front view you can see rectangle for this, like this you can see a rectangle only. But what will be the top view? Again the curved surface. So this part, this surface is showing the rectangle for this curved part. Now we can take the help of this question to understand the same cylindrical and curved surface. Now in the front view you can see this circle and rectangle only, and for this curved it is not visible, so no hidden line will be there because it will look like a straight one. For the top view, for this cylinder you have only a rectangle, just to show the cylinder as a rectangle in top view. Now we will go for the hidden edges. Let's say a cylinder is there. What will be the front view of cylinder? I have discussed that will be a rectangle only, top view a circle only. But let's say the same circle is having the hidden edge, means it is having a groove inside, a material is removed, a hollow cylinder is there. So if hollow cylinder is there, it will have the edges in this side and this side, same like the outer cylinder. Or I can say this cylinder is inside this, so it will have this also. No doubt from outside you cannot see these internal shapes, but whenever we have to draw, we have to imagine the object like a transparent one, means we have to show those edges also which are present in the object but not visible. So what will be the front view of this? A rectangle for outer, but for inner circle, inner cylinder, the same hidden edges. Now why I have drawn only two hidden edges? Because this edge is there and this edge is there. What about this hidden part? It will be overlap with this object line. So in this object line it is overlapping with hidden line. So whenever a hidden line is overlapped with the object line, you have to draw the object line, not the hidden line. Same at the top. So it is having the two hidden lines, vertical direction. Now this is the top view, two concentric circle of the same hollow cylinder. Now we will see one example for this, for hidden edges. So this side, x side, is given as the front view. So you can see x side as the front view. Now when you see x side as the front view, you can see the surface A and B only. You cannot see the all the internal shapes. But behind this surface, if I say this edge is there which is present but not visible in this side, so it means in the front view here we have to draw one hidden line. Same below this, there is no hidden edge, but here you can see this corner, it will have one hidden edge which we have to make here. So you can see this is the front view, you can see this hidden line. Why this hidden line is coming? Due to this edge. Why this hidden line is coming? Due to this lower edge. Same in the top view, when you see why these two lines and these two lines are coming, these are the hidden lines for this edge and this edge. Throughout a groove is there, zigzag shape groove is there. So this edge and this edge, same this edge and this edge. Always we have to take the, we have to imagine the symmetrical shape of object. Now we will see few practice problems. Let's say this is an object, this will be the front view and top view just by the identification. This is the object just like stairs, this is the front view and top view, identification and levels. This is the object, same front view, top view, and it is having identification and level challenge. Same one more for identification and levels. This is for inclined surface, the front view and top view, how we draw on the sheet. This is the cylindrical surface, front view and top view like this. One more example of the same, cylindrical and cube. For the curved part, like this. On all of these examples, I have made separate videos. If any doubt is there, just do watch those so that you can have more experience of or more understanding of orthographic projection. Now we will learn the orthographic projection with the animations. I have told you we have to use only the first or third quadrant for projection system, but mostly we prefer the first quadrant. If it is not given, then you can go for first angle projection. In few countries they are using the third angle projection, and these are the symbols to represent first angle projection and third angle projection. Now when a first angle projection is there, we have to assume this VP, HP and AVP, auxiliary vertical plane. I have discussed all these things. We have to place this object above HP in front of VP. When you see the front view, you have to stand this side to get the front view, top view and side view. Then we rotate. Now let's say an object is placed above HP in front of VP. This is the first side for front view. Observer has to stand this side. Now it is having a number of hidden features. This is XY line. You can see the shape 3D very easily, but when you see the front view, all the dark part is the hidden part and the light part is the visible part. Now you can see all these dimensions are there. Now when you see the front view, the object is symmetrical about this. Now this part, a rectangle, a cylindrical part will look like a rectangle only. I have discussed all these things, all these features separately. So for cylindrical part, it will be a rectangle, and this is hidden edge because this internal cylinder, internal groove was not clear. Same for this. Step diameter, internal groove is not clear, so we have to show it with hidden edges. Now if you talk about this, this is also the hidden feature. Now it will be more clear if you compare the hidden edges. Now you have to take all the projection lines for top view on HP, but the center line will go like a center line. It will not have the continuous line. From VP to HP, it will go like a center line. Now you can see the top view. From top, this will be the visible part, dark. Now you can see all the dark color part, that is the hidden features. So it means all those we have to show it with hidden lines. These concentric circles, it will be visible from the top, so you can make them dark. But these edges, it will not be visible, and the horizontal holes also, so we have to show them with hidden lines. I'll tell you, then we project it. So in this way we draw front view, top view